This is a Bugs 2 SE. So you gotta hit the unlock button. And then you can take it up in the air. And it is floating everywhere. I just did a compass calibration on it, but let's see, there it goes. It settled in finally. Let's see, the Bugs 2 SC, I'm guessing correctly, is about 3 years old, maybe? Maybe a little bit more, I'm not sure. Anyway, we are recording, so I wanna... This is where I took off from. I'm gonna go forward with it. Let me check the speeds on it. I can't remember the speed button on this one. Okay. I'm not sure if this one has a speed button. I can't remember. It's been a while. What's funny, though, is you watch all these videos, and everybody's showing the newest, latest, and greatest. But there's a lot of drones out there that are just still fun to fly. Let's take it up. Let's see what happens. So we're getting beeps, like we got low signal. I know it's not the battery. Well, it's got it. Well, is the battery actually dead? Yeah, let me see here. It's not showing the battery mode. Oh, shouldn't be. Let me bring it back down. Let's see if it stops. That just tells me it's in the settings. If so, let me bring it back down. I think it's saying the battery's low for some reason. Okay, I have so many drones, it's possible. I mean, I see the battery levels at 2, but I shouldn't be doing this. So, let me go into here, let me hit settings. Okay. I don't know why it's doing that. But it's still recording. I'm gonna fly around until it does something. It's got all the bars blinking in the back, red, and in the front, it's just solid red. So let's see what happens, see how long we can get this thing to fly for. That's crazy, it's like in the first stages of low voltage, LVC, they call it low voltage control. Let's just fly it for a minute, see what happens. So I can't take it up and out like I wanted to. It's okay, I'll charge it up and get it out there. I have 2 or 3 different batteries that I can use on this thing. I just choose the stock one. Like I said, which is probably a couple years old. Let me see if I can get this thing up in here and get that sunset over here. Or the clouds. Let's see what happens. It's still going up. Fly it forward. This is a stationary camera. Yeah, it does. It's actually, I thought the battery was charged up, but you can actually see where it's at right now. It's just right up there. It's not too far up, but I was trying to catch a little bit of the sunset with it, which it's a stationary camera. It's one of my cheaper drones. I have a bunch. I fly all the time. It's beeping because the battery's low, and I didn't realize I didn't charge it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
that's
so you,
cool.
But you can pull it backwards and kind of catch
a
little
license?
Bit. Yeah, yeah, I got my.
I was thinking about doing that.
Yeah, I mean, you only need one if you get one over a certain weight, which this one just is about 350 grams, so anything over 250, uh-huh. You need to get a license for it. But you can get the Mavic Mini. This was like a $150, $200 drone, a cheaper one, but it works great. It's fun to fly. And some of the other ones I got a Mavic Pro Platinum. I can fly it to the government plaza from here.
Wow.
And like go over government and Demetropolis right there. So it just all depends on.
You've never lost one?
About 3 of them, yeah. It was like six.
Do you have insurance on?
No, it was an older Phantom 3. It was like $600 drone and I didn't reset it and I hit the return to home. Instead of coming home, it just went that way. It's somewhere.
What's return to home?
It's like so right here, you got a button. So It, yeah, what it is, if you don't calibrate, there's a compass in it. So it's kind of like, you know, you got a compass in your hand. So you gotta rotate it and do these little spins. It's called a compass calibration. If you don't do it right, you can lose it.
Somewhere.
Yeah, it's somewhere in somebody's tree or somebody found it. Have a good one. Hear that owl, that's for sure.